Hi everyone, in this video I'm sharing 7 essential Lightroom tips that will instantly save you time and increase your productivity. Tip number 1. If you're not using shortcuts yet, now is the perfect time to integrate them into your workflow. In the Library module, select an image and press D to instantly switch to the Develop module. Once you've finished editing, press G to return to the Library module grid view. Press F in either the Library or Develop module to view the image full screen. Press F again to return to the previous view. To crop an image, simply press R, which takes you directly to the crop tool, regardless of whether you're in the Library or Develop module. Press X while using the crop tool to rotate the crop orientation. Use Q to quickly access the spot removal tool, and while doing so, pressing A will show the visualized spots overlay. During editing, press the backslash key to toggle a before and after preview of your adjustments. Tip number 2. Make use of presets to streamline common editing tasks and to add effects. I've created a Lightroom Tools preset pack specifically for this purpose, and it's available for free through the link in the description below if you're interested. I use most of these effects in nearly all of my edits, and these presets save me a lot of time by eliminating the need to recreate the effect manually on every image I edit. You can quickly add any effect you've programmed into a preset. To create your own, first apply the effect you want, then click the plus icon under presets, check the box next to the specific effects you want to include, name the preset, choose the group, and save it. You can then use the preset on your next edit. Tip number 3. When editing, if you want to reset a specific slider, instead of dragging it back to zero, simply double-click the slider for a quick reset. Additionally, holding down the Alt or Option key will reveal the option to reset entire groups of sliders. You'll notice the category name changes to include the word reset. Just click on it to reset the entire group at once. Tip number 4. When you have a large batch of photos to cull, I highly recommend building one-to-one previews. This allows you to quickly move between images and evaluate sharpness without waiting for Lightroom to generate previews for each photo. To render one-to-one previews, go to the Library module, select the images you want to review, then navigate to Library, Previews, and choose Build One-to-One Previews. A dialog box will notify you once the process is complete. Another helpful tip when rating, labeling, or flagging images is to turn on Caps Lock. This enables Lightroom to automatically advance to the next image after you assign a rating, color label, or flag, eliminating the need to manually press the arrow key to go to the next photo. Tip number 5. Use Smart Collections to automatically group images based on specific criteria. I use Smart Collections to display all of my 3, 4, and 5 star rated images, as well as 4 and 5 star images that haven't been edited yet. This helps me quickly find new photos to work on. I also have Smart Collections that show images without location or species keywords, allowing me to make sure my catalog is up to date. The possibilities for Smart Collections are endless, and to create one, go to your Collections tab, click the plus icon, and select Smart Collection. Name your collection, choose the criteria, and then click Create. Tip number 6. To ensure Lightroom runs as efficiently as possible, it's crucial to configure certain catalog settings correctly. Start by going into Lightroom Preferences and selecting the Performance tab. Increase your Camera Raw cache size to between 20 to 30 gigabytes, depending on the available space on your hard drive. As a general guideline, set the cache to about 20% of your remaining hard drive space, and make sure the cache location is on your main internal drive. Further down in the Performance tab, you'll see the Optimize Catalog option. I recommend optimizing your catalog once a week, but I do this during the catalog backup process rather than from this tab. To set up backups, go to Catalog Settings and, under the General tab, locate the Backup section. Choose how frequently you'd like to backup your catalog, and you'll be given the option to optimize it during the backup. I recommend backing up your catalog once a week. Next, decrease the resolution of your standard preview size. These are the previews shown in the grid or loop view in the Library module. Go to File Handling and set the standard preview size to 2048 pixels or smaller. This will allow you to browse through the grid view more quickly. I recommend setting the preview quality to medium. If Lightroom is running slowly, try lowering both the preview quality and the standard preview size. I also set one-to-one previews to be discarded after 1 week. One crucial setting that can significantly slow down Lightroom if misconfigured is found under the Metadata tab. Ensure that the automatically write changes to XMP option is unchecked. This prevents Lightroom from continuously writing changes to the sidecar files of the images you're editing. Tip number 7. Keep your Lightroom catalog and preview cache in the same folder on your local hard drive rather than on an external drive. Keeping the Lightroom catalog on an external drive can create a serious bottleneck due to slower data transfer speeds between the device and the drive. Storing your photographs on an external drive is perfectly fine. A common cause of slow editing is poor Lightroom organization. If this is something you struggle with and you'd like to see how I set up my Lightroom catalog, check out this video next.